All right. Joining us this morning again, Abacor Capital Holdings CEO Regina Mandanas. Hi, Regina. Good morning.
Yes, happy. Good morning.
All right, we can hear you perfectly now. So just a full disclosure, I know, Regina, you are running for a party list post in the coming May elections, but for today, we're just going to limit to our discussion to talking about Abacor. All right, so Regina, let's start with this. Very recently, Abacor sold a 21,000 square meter property in Lipa, Batangas to the Gaysana Group for about $17 million, and another 4,800 square meters to a meat processing company for $41 million. Regina, I'm very curious, what is the rationale for unloading these parcels of land? And do you have plans to sell even more?
Well, we have a land bank of about 330 hectares, mm-hmm. and this is the opportune time to really utilize the economic potential of the province of Batangas. Mm-hmm. It will rebound this year because of the gradual lifting of restrictions and a very strong interest from international investors.
Oh, wow. Strong interest from international investors. Could you give us some clues as to if there are specific groups, foreign groups already looking to set up shop in Batangas?
Well, there are various foreign groups already situated in the business parks in mm-hmm. in the province. However, because of the Batangas port and also its accessibility to Metro Manila, with all the various infrastructure as a result of the Build program, we've been able to attract a lot of Metro Manilans post-COVID, during COVID and post-COVID, to relocate in the province of Batangas.
Okay, and how much investments are you looking? How much new investments are we looking at?
Well, there is a real estate development in Batangas City from a New Zealand group mm-hmm. for real estate development, who's committed to invest about $100 million mm-hmm. in a few months. That's very from a foreign group. And we also have the Energy Hub, mm-hmm. the ABA Energy Hub, which is about 103 hectares devoted to energy. And 2 hectares of this was sold to the A. Brown Group mm-hmm. for liquefied natural gas. So we're also meeting the needs for as far as electricity and mm-hmm. power for the province of Batangas, enabling our citizens to have cheaper electricity and those who choose to relocate to the province.
Mm-hmm. Of course, we'll talk about these two projects later on because Abacor is also part of those joint ventures. But give us the big picture. Give us a sense of this growing interest to be in Batangas. What do you think is driving that?
Our property values in Metro Manila have reached 700,000 per square meter. Mm-hmm. In Cebu, it's about 100,000 per square meter. But Batangas, with the infrastructure accessibility, is only 15 to 20,000 per square meter. So you get a lot of value for your money mm-hmm. as far as like investment okay. in is concerned.
Ah, okay.
Also, it's fully developed. We have a full, we have ease of doing business in the province, as well as very strong partnership with the local government in encouraging businesses to transfer there.
Mm-hmm. Very very good news for your shareholders. You mentioned this earlier, so I want to delve into it. One of your subsidiaries, Omnicor, has entered into a $100 million joint venture. This is what you mentioned, Starfleet Innotech, the New Zealand-based asset management. And you guys are developing a resort-like condotel property. What is the latest on that? When are you going to start building? When is it going to start operations? And what kind of money and foot traffic are you expecting to attract with that venture?
Actually, currently, that area owned by Omnicor already has the largest statue of the Blessed Mother located there. Mm. I'm not sure our team was able to send you pictures of that.
Okay.
I guess they did send you that material. Mm-hmm. However, around that area, there's also it's close to the center of marine biodiversity, which makes it very attractive to foreign investors, mm-hmm. especially who are interested in the wellness industry. Mm-hmm. So basically, without disclosing the nature of the business of this real estate developer, that is the overall picture. To have a condotel, international caliber, yet affordable, wellness-centered real estate development.
Regina, I know there's also a temple that's being built there, a very big temple. Is it the same area?
It's the same area.
A Taoist temple, which is very big, actually.
Yes, it's very big. It's about, we donated a 1 hectare towards mm-hmm. that. However, built solely from temple devotees, and it's a Taoist temple. So the Chinese are very attracted also to Batangas at this time.
And this Condotel project within the area, when is it going to begin operations?
Well, we're starting the actual groundwork, ironically, like in a couple of weeks.
Oh, okay. Only,
which is the time when COVID restrictions for travelers from New Zealand have eased. Mm-hmm. So it's an international group, and with post-COVID, everybody is like redrawing its plans as far as real estate development. So everything is green, wellness, towards that direction, mm-hmm. which is exactly what Batangas is espousing, you know, makakalikasan, which is like to honor, you know, our natural resources and environment.
All
which
right.
is as well.
So when you start work in the next couple of weeks, when do you begin operations for that Condotel project?
Well, we're Omnicare is like a passive investor. We allow our real estate developers to take the lead. Mm-hmm. We just encourage them as far as giving them all the assistance they need to be able, mm-hmm. since they're, you know, to be able to really have ease of doing business in the Philippines. Mm-hmm. A lot of them are not familiar with our laws and regulations. So part of our company policy also is to be able to encourage our partners to, you know, transcend all these limitations,
all right.
which are normally perceived by foreign investors in our country. In a way, we're helping our country, but most specifically, we're helping Batangas by encouraging more investors and generating more jobs for the Batangas.
All right. The company, you know, started many years ago, and you started out as a mining company, and then you expanded into real estate, gaming through your stake in Pacific Online Systems. We'll get to that later. And energy. For the energy, which you mentioned earlier, the ABA Energy Hub, in 2021, ABACOR announced plans to buy Simlong Energy Development for 900 million pesos. Simlong was, you know, the one planning to build that energy industrial park there. That deal was completed, correct?
Yes, that deal was completed.
And where are you on that project?
We are, well, at least we have the foreign investors also finalizing the whatever needs to be done to be able to operate. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We are a holding company. We have various interests in various fields, but in this case, real estate development is our core business. Mm-hmm. And at this point, since I became president, our thrust is to develop them, but with strategic partners.
Mm-hmm. And what's really interesting is when these developments happen, the value of all the surrounding areas also go up, which is also beneficial to ABACOR and its shareholders. Regina, you know, what really excited a lot of your investors in the past few years or in the past few months is your tie-up with Squid Pay. Marvin de la Cruz's Squid Pay for that 1.5 billion peso digital bank. This is, of course, going to happen through your PhilStar Development Bank. And Squid Pay was going to pump in, what, 900 million for a 60% stake. Is that plan moving along as well? Because the BSP only released 6 digital banking licenses.
That's right, Mimi. Unfortunately, Squid Pay was not able to, the big players were able to get into the digital business. Mm. Aware. So Squid Pay was not one of those who are, you know, in the core business at this time. So the central bank, being very cautious, just gave the licenses to the established mainstream banks as business. So Squid Pay was not able to come up with the restrictions or limitations which were imposed by the central bank.
So this deal didn't complete?
It didn't
materialize.
Because, yes, the central bank said they're only limiting it to 6, and it was limited to 6 major banks.
All right. But you're not giving up on your digital banking dream? On fintech,
well,
perhaps?
We have an investor for PhilStar who put in a lesser amount, but a more conservative. But it's also a group that believes in the viability of a regional bank. Mm. So they have invested in that bank.
All right. All right. Regina,
that's for Phil.
Okay, this is for your bank. Regina, you have a powerhouse of a board. Your board members are big names. Correct me if I'm wrong, you've got Bernie Villegas on the board, a renowned economist. The O'Shea, Willie O'Shea is also part of the board of Premier Leisure. The Tieng brothers are also part of your board, of the Solar Group. And so I guess it's interesting to think what sort of conversation happens when the board gathers. What's the sense that you're getting? What seems to be the board's outlook for 2022 and 2023 as the Philippine economy hopefully successfully exits from the pandemic?
I'm very proud of the board because it's been with us through thick and thin. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, that they have faith in the overall value of the company. And they're a brain trust. So they bring to us the wisdom of all their experience from mm-hmm. their various businesses. And they're very bullish about especially the choices of the properties which we've invested in. And what they are asking, though, is that when we do sell off our interest in certain properties, we acquire more to be able to develop more. Mm. So it's depleting the reserves of the land bank. They want us to like have a continual bank, you know, of properties to develop, so the work will never end. Specifically, Omar Cruz, a former city banker and treasurer of the Philippines. Mm-hmm. He calls you from time to time to say, Regina, if you're going to sell off, you have to buy more. So like we have to always be on the lookout for, and it forces us to also look at Batangas, which is our core competency, and see what other areas are viable for development.
Regina,
so it's a win-win.
Win-win indeed, but are you open to exploring opportunities outside of Batangas?
We do have opportunity. We do have investments in other areas. We have mines in Mindanao, and mm-hmm. you know, when mines are like, you know, specifically like not in coal, we have a coal mine in Surigao. We have a gold mine in Agusan, and when those the right partner comes along with clean. Well, our philosophy is always like environmental, clean, safe. Mm-hmm. So when they provide the right technology, then mm-hmm. we will allow them to exploit our license or utilize our license.
But what about in the real estate part? Are you planning to do land banking in other areas of the country outside of Batangas?
For now, we have limited ourselves to Batangas, which is large enough, and areas which are really basically not discovered, undiscovered jewels for our country. Accessibility as far as infrastructure and the people and the workforce and just the climate. A lot of people have relocated there due to COVID, and we invite you to be our guest when you're free.
All right. Looking forward to that. Congratulations on the new deals that you have, Regina. We hope to have you back on the show when there are more exciting developments, not just for Abacor, but for Batangas as well. Thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Take care. Have a good weekend.
All right.
Thank you.